And let's thank the Lord for the day. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for this awesome day in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit, we declare that you are welcome in this place. Father, have your way in us, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus, for this awesome week that we have started. Father, we give you all the praise and glory in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we give you all title to this meeting, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let every protocol breaking prayer be acceptable. Hallelujah. As we begin this week, oh God, we begin this week with you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We are taking spiritual control over this week. And as we take spiritual control over this week, we take control over the entire rest of the month of June and over the year. Hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you, Lord, that you are a God that removes mountains. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want you to start typing in the comment section, this mountain shall be removed. This mountain must be removed, hallelujah. It must be removed, hallelujah. That is our theme as we kick off for the week. As you know, Monday morning is our Monday where we set up for the whole week and we command the entire week. So not only are we commanding the morning, but we are also commanding the entire week. And as we command this week, the theme that we kick off with on this Monday is that this mountain must be removed by the Holy Spirit. The Lord is going to show us the mountains that we need to remove from our lives. Amen, somebody. This mountain must be removed. I'm waiting for you to start making those comments. Hallelujah. This mountain must be removed. I see you. I see you. This mountain must be removed. Hallelujah. Those of you who are joining us for the first time, this is the Protocol Breaking Prayer Platform. Hallelujah. This is the altar where we make protocol breaking prayers, where we make declarations and decrees, and we start the week with the word of God. Hallelujah. Talk to me, somebody. This mountain must be removed. I start off with the scripture from Zechariah chapter 4 verse 6. Hallelujah. If you are making notes, the Bible says in Zechariah chapter 4 verse 6, and I'm reading from the King James Version, it says, "Then he answered and spoke unto me, saying, this is the word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel, saying, not by might, not by power, but by my spirit, said the Lord of hosts. Who art thou, O great mountain, before Zerubbabel? Thou shall become a plain, and he shall bring forth the headstone thereof with shoutings, crying, grace, grace unto it." Amen, somebody. Let me take it slower because I need you to absorb this prophetic word this morning. Hallelujah. Then he answered. Hallelujah. Then he answered. Somebody type, "Then he answered." Then he answered. For there to have been an answer, that means there must have been a question. Talk to me, somebody. There is an answer that is coming to somebody this morning. There is an answer to a question that has been asked. There is an answer to a request that has been made continuously. Talk to me, somebody. Tell your neighbor, "He answered." He is a God that answers. He's not a God that ignores people. He's not a God that ignores his children. When you go to your father and you ask a question, you expect a response. When you ask you have a particular request to your father, he will definitely give that thing to you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says that he answered. So whether he answers by an angel, whether he answers by a prophetic word, that prophetic word, whatever vessel he chooses to use, has definitely come to you this morning. Then he answered. And I continue with the scripture in verse 6. It says, "He spoke unto me." Hallelujah. "And he spoke unto me." Somebody say, "Spoke to me." The Lord is specific. The Lord is specific this morning. He is speaking specifically. This scripture is proof positive that God is not speaking a generalized word. He came and he spoke a specific word. I want you to declare it, that the Lord is speaking to me this morning. Every word that will proceed from my mouth under the unction of the Holy Ghost is proceeding, speaking to you directly. The Lord is speaking to you directly, Eunice. The Lord is speaking to you directly, Nwashe, on Brenda. The Lord is speaking directly to you. He spoke unto me, not anybody else. He's not speaking to your neighbor. He's speaking to you. Talk to me, somebody. He said, and he was what? Saying. That is the next word, right? He said something. And that is what we are gathered here this morning to know. What is he saying? This is the word of the Lord. This is not a word of your pastor. This is not the word of your prophet. Or this is not the word of your uncle. This is not a word of your friend. This is not a message from your uncle or your father or your physical mother on earth. But this is the word of the Lord. Somebody type it again. Type it in that comment section. this is the word of the Lord. This is the word of the Lord. Talk to me, somebody. Hallelujah. This mountain must be removed. Hallelujah. This is the word of the Lord. Then the scripture continues, is saying, unto Zerubbabel. Hallelujah. It is a specific word, hallelujah, that was delivered. And that gives me proof positive response that God is speaking to somebody. Am I communicating to somebody this morning? Somebody type it again. God is speaking to me right now. God is speaking to me. This is the word of the Lord. This is the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. This is not a word to a stranger. Hallelujah. This is a word that will dispel all confusion. This is a word that speaks specifically to somebody. When you look at the meaning of the word Zerubbabel, you begin to understand that he was not speaking to just anybody. This is not a stranger in Babylon. This is a specific word to somebody. Talk to me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is speaking to you, Abiela. Gundo, God is speaking to you. Mam Kefi, God is speaking to you this morning. Hallelujah. He says, saying, not by might, not by power. So God is saying, stop stressing, stop fretting. This thing is not by your strength. This thing is not by your power. I know you are endued with power. I know you carry power. I know I put that power inside of you. I know you have strength, but this is not the strength. This battle does not require your strength. Hallelujah, somebody. This is a battle. This task of moving this mountain is a task that needs me. He says it will be by my spirit. Hallelujah. Somebody type it in that comment section that it is by the spirit of the Lord. He says it is by my spirit. It is by the Holy Spirit. Who is the Holy Spirit? He's the counselor. He's the wonderful counselor. He's the teacher. He's the advocate. He is the one who is your comforter. Hallelujah. He says it is by my spirit. This battle is won by the spirit of the Lord. This mountain is moving by the spirit of the Lord. This mountain is moving by the spirit of the Lord. It is by my spirit, says the Lord. Hallelujah. When I continue with verse 7, he says, who art thou? There is a name attached to this mountain. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want you to understand that this mountain has a name. Hallelujah. He doesn't say which. He doesn't refer to it as an object, but he says, who? Who are you? Who are you? Who are you who has been daring me? Who are you who has been blocking me? Karaba soko tekedia maha. Shakolebe se tekia basata kari. Hallelujah. This mountain, who are you, oh great mountain? Hallelujah. Because this mountain has magnified itself. Because this problem has magnified itself in front of you. Who are you? Who are you before me? Who are you before Zerubbabel? Remember, this scripture is talking to you. Who are you who is trying to bring confusion in my life? Who are you who is trying to bring confusion? Who are you? You are going to be dispelled this morning. Who are you, O great mountain, before Zerubbabel? Thou shalt become a plain. He says you will be leveled. This is not the morning where we are needing to climb mountains. Child of God, this is not the day where we are needing to go over mountains. This is the day that you arose to level the mountain. Am I communicating to somebody? We are leveling. Tell your neighbor, we are leveling. It's becoming a plane. We are not going over. We are not going and we are not. We are leveling it completely. Who are you, O mountain? He says, he shall bring forth the headstone thereof. He shall bring the headstone. What is a stone? A stone is a rock. Who is the rock? The rock that is stronger than you. Who is Jesus? Who is the church? He shall bring forth the headstone thereof with shoutings, with crying, grace, grace unto it. That means when the headstone comes out after your crying, they shall look at you and they shall say, you are beautiful. Grace, favor, favor, favor shall be spoken of you after the leveling of that mountain. Another translation, it says, the angel told me to give Zerubbabel this message. My God, my God, my God, my God, this message that you will succeed. Not by military might, not by your own strength. Talk to me, somebody. Not by your own strength, but by my spirit. Any obstacle or any great mountain that is standing before you, it will disappear before you. The scripture says it will disappear before you in the name of Jesus Christ. It is by my spirit. You will rebuild the temple. And as you put the last stone in place, the people will shout beautiful. When you put that last stone, when the church is rebuilt, come on somebody, hallelujah. The angel explained, it was the following message of the Lord to Zerubbabel. I am the Lord, I'm all powerful. Don't depend on your own power. Don't depend on your own strength, but depend on my spirit. Hallelujah. Zerubbabel, the mountain in front of you will be leveled to the ground. Bonnie, the mountain before you will be leveled before you. Eunista, your mountain is going to be leveled this morning in the name of Jesus. Oh, Jesus, help me, Jesus. Hallelujah. And they will shout and they'll say, God has been very kind. I said to you, when you look at that scripture, it says, are you? Verse 7 says, who are you? That means that thing has a name. There is a name. Who art thou, O great mountain? Every mountain has a name. Every single mountain has a name. For you to fight properly, to retain your destiny, you have to know the name of the mountain in front of you. Hallelujah. When somebody is knocking at the door of your house or your office, you ask, who is there? Who is knocking? Who is trying to knock down your success? Who is trying to knock down your prosperity? Who is trying to knock down your health? What is that thing that, what does it call itself? That illness, that sickness, that cervical cancer, what are you? Who are you? So, child of God, the question of who are you is more important. Whenever you are facing a mountain, you need to understand what challenges that you are facing. You need to ask, who are you? When you know who it is, then the where and the how and the who, everything just comes together. Talk to me, somebody. The where will come. Hallelujah. When you know who you are fighting, you know where to find the person. At least you know who to look for. You know where to Google, where you are sending your GPS to fight the person who is fighting you. Talk to me, somebody. Hallelujah. There is a name. Hallelujah. This mountain. Somebody type it. This mountain. There's a this mountain. Look at the word this mountain. This. What is the this that you are fighting? What is the this that is an issue in your life? It is specific. Any specific problem. Hallelujah. Any specific problem or need that you have in your life that appears so big. It says, oh, you great mountain. Who are you? Oh, great mountain that is so magnifying itself above God. Who are you magnifying yourself above God? A mountain is any problem that presents itself in a magnitude, like it's a huge magnitude. Any impossible problem that is trying to show itself impossible. Thank God that we serve a God of possibilities. Anything that tries to bring you to shame, that it is this mountain we are talking about this morning. It's trying to bring shame to you. It is trying to bring you humiliation. This mountain, yes, Mom Kathy, this mountain, who are you? Hallelujah. You are trying to shame me. You are trying to humiliate me. Anything that robs you of your fulfillment as a child of God, this mountain that is trying to rob you of your fulfillment as a child of God. Mountains can even represent human beings. That mountain can be a human being. It can be an obstruction, a hindrance to your progress. Now we need to know who it is. Habakkuk 3:10 says, the mountain saw thee and they trembled. The overflowing of the water passed by. The deep uttered his voice and lifted up his hands on high. Oh, talk to me, somebody. I said there is a Goliath that needs to go down. It must be removed. This mountain called Goliath must be removed. Pharaoh was a mountain and he had to be removed. Herod was a mountain and he had to be removed. Oh, come on, somebody. You need to tap louder. Hallelujah. You need to shout that amen well. You need to make sure that you're thundering that amen. Hallelujah. Talk to me. Hallelujah. Talk to me so I talk to you. Hallelujah. Makoria basunda, kalia masunda. Make a demand on the anointing for the word of God to come through for you. Pharaoh was a mountain. Herod was a mountain. It could be any platform where your enemies are standing. They are trying to launch an attack against you. That is a mountain. This mountain must be removed. Somebody type it in that comment section. This mountain must be removed. That which is making you stumble. Jeremiah 13 says that you must remove that thing that is trying to make you lose your path, that thing that is making you stumble, that thing that is wanting you to throw you into the pit. This mountain, It could be any satanic opposition, any satanic conspiracy that threatens to hinder or destroy you. This mountain must be removed. I said it could be anything. This mountain, whatever you are, who are you? This mountain, is it an ancestral curse? This mountain must be removed. I said that ancestral curse must be removed. Come on, somebody. You need to share this live broadcast. The Holy Spirit needs to speak. Mara official, we need to populate heaven. Come on, come on, come on. Let's take it up. It could be an ancestral curse that needs to be moved. I don't know what is that curse that you have been battling with, but that mountain, this mountain must be removed. It could be a long-standing problem. I don't care how chronic they said it is. I don't care how they said how terminal it is. This mountain, it has to be removed. That thing that presents itself as if it does not have a solution, this mountain has to be removed. Cancer is a mountain. I want you to declare it that this cancer must be removed. It has a name. Once you name it, you can command it. You can declare it. You can recreate whatever you want to recreate in your life. This mountain must be removed. Cancer is a name. Barrenness is a mountain. This mountain of barrenness must be removed. You will conceive your child this year in the name of Jesus Christ. Your womb shall be fruitful in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Failure is a mountain. Defeat is a mountain. Any chronic illness is a mountain. Talk to me. Hallelujah. Karoshokoniyama. Any chronic poverty is a mountain. Any repetitive poverty, you can't be born in poverty, live in poverty, give children in poverty. They live in poverty. Their children's, your children's children live in poverty. It must be removed. This mountain. High blood pressure must be removed. Yes, Moose, come on, Kale, shake it here. Arthritis must be removed. Talk to me, somebody. Name it. As you name it, God is dealing with it. I need you to believe it and take this word in and run with it. Kala shake it, take it here, Masota. Hey, in this mountain, Makora Shakata Kadia Baha. In this mountain, somebody type it again. This mountain shall be removed. Oh, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. This mountain must be removed. Debt is a serious problem that needs to be removed. Financial crisis after financial crisis, it must be removed. Debt must be removed. Financial blockages must be removed. Oh, Jesus. Oh, God knows the size of your mountain, child of God. God knows. Isaiah says, who have measured the waters in the hollow of his hand and measured out heaven with the span, hallelujah, and comprehended the dust of the earth and in a measure and weighed the mountains in scales and the hills in a balance. He knows the size of your mountain. It is not about size. Talk to me, somebody. Every mountain has a foundation. Hallelujah. For a fire is kindled in my anger and shall burn unto the lowest hell and shall consume the earth and with her increase and set on fire the foundations of the mountains. What is the foundation of the mountain that you are dealing with? What is this mountain? What is the foundation? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When the mountain is destroyed, it crumbles. That is why we are leveling it. We are leveling the plains. Hallelujah. Go karabashata kalia masundo. In the name of Jesus Christ. Mountains melt before the Lord. This is what the word of God says. And we stand on it this morning. Mountains shall be leveled. Hallelujah. Mountains will be melting before the Lord. Hallelujah. You are commanding the Lord of hosts. Do you understand that this is an instruction from the head, the chief of the army? He's saying, I'm the Lord. This is the word from the Lord. He didn't say this is not the word from your father. He said this is the word from the Lord. The God is very intentional when he speaks. When he speaks and he mentions the word Lord, Lord is what you use for somebody who is a commander, who is a chief, who is in charge, who is a ruler, who is a king, who is giving he's a commander in chief. He is saying, I am sending out my army to level this mountain. You are not asking Abba Father here. This is not the word from Abba Father. This is the word from the Lord himself. He says, I'm ready to go on to battle for you. Mountains melt before the Lord. That is Judges 5:5. The mountains melted before the Lord. Hallelujah. Even that Sinai from before the Lord of God of Israel. So all you need is the presence of the Lord. When you have the presence of the Lord, the mountains will be leveled. When you have the presence of the Lord, the mountains will be crumbling. Hallelujah. God removes mountains. You need to understand that you serve a God that removes mountains. Job 9:5, he says, which removeth mountains, and they know not which overturneth them in his anger. My God, do you understand that you have evidence and witness in the word of God repeatedly? Job says he removes mountains and they know not which overturns them in his anger. When he's angry, when his child is not fulfilled, when his child is not doing well. My God, God is a God that overturns mountains at their roots. He's going to deal with your mountains at the root level. Job 28:9, he says, he putteth forth his hand upon the rock. He overturns the mountain by the roots. I want you to uproot every mountain that has been fighting you. I want you to uproot it. We are uprooting it by the root. This mountain must be removed. When an earthquake comes and the mountain is leveled, we are uprooting the root level. There's no foundation that will remain. Oh, child of God, you need to know how to deal with mountains. Karabashokotia. We have an anointing. We have an anointing for beating mountains. Hallelujah. We have an anointing that can beat mountains small. Isaiah 41 verse 15 says, behold, I will make thee a new sharp threshing instrument having teeth. Thou shalt thresh the mountains and beat them small, and shall make the hills as sharp. Do you see it? Do you see it? The prophet confirms it. He says, you shall thresh the mountains and beat them small. Beat that mountain small. Stamp it on with your feet. Beat it small. How do you deal with mountains, Pastor Fortune? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You must have your faith in God activated all the time. It takes faith to move mountains. Hallelujah. To remove this mountain, it will need your faith. Your faith will not fail. Hallelujah. Ah, kariya basanda. Have a faith that moves mountains. Kariya sekete. Your most valuable asset is your faith. Your faith is your most valuable asset. Ah, whosoever is born of God overcometh the world. And this is the victory that overcomes the world. Even our faith. Faith is more than belief. Do you understand that it's more than your belief? This is our faith that overcomes the world. You need to act on the word of God. Act on the word of God. Act on the word of God, which you believe on. It comes by hearing. And right now you are hearing it. Hallelujah. You will beat that mountain small. Slay, you are going to beat it small. Hallelujah. Your faith will determine the quality of your life. The quality of your life in the kingdom of God that you are called. You are a kingdom person. Do you understand that you're a kingdom citizen? There is a standard. There is a quality of life that you need to be living. Hallelujah. It is the currency in the kingdom of God. Your faith must be activated. Resist doubt. Kasha kata kadia. How are you going to level this mountain? How am I going to move this mountain? I'm going to remove doubt. I'm going to remove doubt from my spirit. I'm going to remove doubt. I'm not going to listen to nonsense from anybody else. I don't doubt my God. I don't doubt the word of God. You will not doubt. Whoever shall not doubt in his heart. Focus on God. Focus on the attributes of God. Focus on the attributes of his faithfulness. Focus on his integrity. Focus on his mercy. Focus on his generosity. Focus on the goodness of the Lord. Am I communicating to somebody? How do you focus on God? How do you make sure that you resist? You go out and you shut the negative thoughts out. Shut down. Shut. Go into your prayer closet. Go into that room and shut the door. Somebody say, shut the door. Shut that door. When you shut that door, you shut out the negativity, you shut out the confusion, you shut out the negative comments, the negative doubt that are trying to, you shut out the feelings, the fickle feelings from friends. You shut out friends, shut the door. Oh, come on, somebody, tell your neighbor, shut the door, shut the door. This is scriptural. He says, when you pray, this is what you do. Go into your room. Go into your private room where nobody enters and shut the door. When you shut the door, there is no thought that is supposed to distract you. Shut the door. Oh, kalama shata kadia baha. And you go there and tarry and you wait. You wait for as long as it takes. The problem is that sometimes when we go into our private room, when we go into our prayer closet, we don't wait long enough because the thought comes, the devil attacks you. The reason why God says shut the door, because he knows the devil is going to try and implant thoughts that are going to distract you. The kind of thoughts that remind you that you sinned last night, that you fornicated last week, you committed adultery yesterday. The kind of thoughts that tell you you are not worthy. The kind of thoughts that tell you, you, what mountain can you move? He wants to laugh at you. You need to shut the door. Tell your neighbor, shut the door. Oh, Fortunel Online, come on, talk to me, somebody. Shut the door. Oh, Jesus. You need to tap those likes. Hi, hallelujah. Talia, shut the door. Hallelujah. Resist doubt. Be prepared to wait until you don't let go. You hold on. You hold on to that leg of that angel and say, I will not let you go until you bless me. Until this mountain is moved, I am not letting you go. Oh, Jesus. Get rid of sin from your life. Don't be so vulnerable that you are always trying to duck and dive. Oh no, am I worthy today? Did I sin? You know what the Lord does not like. You know, get rid of sin from your life. Sin destroys your confidence. So we want you to be confident. We want you to come to that altar with confidence. When you constantly repent today, you repent, you just up and down like this. It paralyzes you. Sin paralyzes you. It destroys your confidence. It destroys your faith. Most people have confidence in God, but not in themselves, because they feel unworthy and unqualified. So make up your mind that your mountain is worthy enough to be moved. If your mountain is worthy enough to be moved, then you begin to understand that there are certain things you are not going to continue majoring in sin at the risk of the future of your life. At the risk of the future of your destiny, at the risk of the future of your children. This is a fight. We're not going to compromise our strategy. We're not going to compromise our head, our commander-in-chief. We are not going to compromise our strategy in battle. Talk to me, somebody. Yes, I love that. I love seeing that. I'm confident. Speak against the mountain. How do you deal with this mountain? How am I going to deal with it? Pastor Fortune, help me. Speak to the mountain. It is listening. It's got an ear. Cancer has an ear. High blood pressure has an ear. Money has an ear. Not only money is not only a voice, but it also has an ear. Speak to your finances. Speak to the altars that are fighting you. This mountain. Speak against that mountain. Whatever mountain is fighting you, talk to me, somebody. Oh, somebody type it again. This mountain must be removed. This mountain must be removed. Diabetes must be removed. You cannot accept, and somebody tells you, this is a hereditary thing. It's a genetic thing in my family. Fight it. Make up your mind that you are the generation that stops that trend, that pattern. You are the one that stops that hereditary issue. Lord, you did not create me for diabetes. Lord, you did not create me for genetic issues. You created me a perfect being. You made me perfect. You were not manufactured imperfectly. So you remind him and say, God, you knew me before I was formed in my mother's womb. You did not bring me for suffering. Oh, Jesus, speak against the mountain. Mountains will move at the name of Jesus. There is a name that is above any other name of that mountain. That is the name of Jesus. Ezekiel 6:2 says, Son of man, set thy face towards the mountains of Israel and prophesy against them. I speak to you, Bunte. I speak to you, Anna. I speak to you, Gunde. I speak to you, Mam Kathy. I speak to you, Nwashe. Set your face to the mountains that are facing you. Prophesy against them. Ezekiel 6:3 says, and say this, you mountains of Israel, hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord God to the mountains and to the hills, to the rivers and to the valleys. Behold, I will bring a sword upon you and I will destroy your high places. Oh, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Oh, I hope this word is getting through to somebody. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Speak to the mountain. Prophesy against that mountain. Speak, tell it that you're going to bring it down. You are leveling it. Ezekiel 36:1. Issue a specific command. A specific command. You have been given the I don't know what they call it in the military, but you have command. You are the command and the control. You are the head and not the tail. You are a mighty man of valor.
a mighty woman of valor, speak to the mountain, command the mountain, and it will obey. We don't describe the mountain. We don't complain about the mountain. We speak to the mountain. Am I communicating? Let me talk to you, Facebook people, because you are more alive right now. I don't know what TikTok. Maybe TikTok is still coming. Let me wait for them. Speak to the mountain. Don't describe the problem. Don't describe the mountain. Don't describe and complain about the mountain. Speak to the mountain. They can hear you. Tell the mountain what to do. For verily, verily, I say unto you that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed and be cast into the sea, my God, it shall be done. They have to respond to the word of the Lord. He's the Lord of hosts. He's the chief in command. Sokadia masotokodia. How do you deal with these mountains? You direct the seeds that you sow. Whenever you are sowing seeds, if you are sowing a seed, a financial seed, you want to remove financial barrenness, you direct, speak to the mountain. I'm speaking to the mountain that is dealing with my finances. I'm speaking to the mountain that is making me poor, that I'm barren in my finances. Oh my God. The kind of mountain that does not respond to prayer only and fasting. That it needs your command. It needs you to talk to it. It needs you to declare. It needs you to prophesy against it. Mountain moving faith. Mountain sowing seeds. Mountain moving sowing seeds. It needs you to engage in warfare prayer. You did not wake up to come and play. So don't play when you're on this platform. You came to deal with this mountain. You came to remove this mountain. You remove the mountain with your warfare in your praise and worship. Must be engaged. You engage in warfare. That's why I feel pity for people who wait for when you are thinking of, I've already been prophesying since I started talking. I've already been praying since I started talking from the start of this broadcast. Somebody is waiting for me to say and specifically say something and say, now I prophesy for you. No, I've already said it. When the word was going out, every word that you heard that resonated with you, you should have said, I receive. That it was a prophetic word. The word of God itself is prophetic. Ah, this mountain must be removed. Tell your neighbor again, this mountain must be removed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you need to fast, fast. If you need to pray, pray. If you need to speak in tongues, speak in tongues. Confess the word. Hallelujah. Continually, you don't give up. You keep on speaking to the mountain. You keep on fighting. Hallelujah. You keep on taking out the weeds. You keep on exterminating the rodents, the pests, anything that is trying, you know, you add fertilizer, you add water, you supply extra, extra. Harabakodia. You call for help. You have come on this morning, on this altar, to revive your faith, to revive your spirit man, to revive your prayer life. You have come on this altar. Why? Don't live here without moving this mountain. It must be removed. I command every mountain in your life to be uprooted in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let it be uprooted and be dumped into a place where it can never return in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I command every obstacle that is hindering your success to collapse now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I said I collapse every obstacle that has been hindering your success. It is collapsing now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God bless you, Anna. Hallelujah. I say your ways are opening up in the name of Jesus Christ. I see your ways opening up. I see your path opening up in the name of Jesus Christ. Who is standing against my destiny? Who? There is a name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus, because your name is greater than any other name. Every who that is standing against your destiny, I command them to fail in the name of Jesus Christ. I command every who, whoever it is, whoever it is, whoever it is, whoever that mountain is, this mountain, I command them to fail in the name of Jesus Christ. In every area of your life that the enemy has been hiding through anonymity, I pray that the Lord will expose the enemy wherever he is hiding, whoever is. If it is a human being that the enemy has been using against your success and your progress, I command their exposure now in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Jesus. Every mysterious, any unidentified caller, from today, your radar, your spiritual radar, your eyes are spiritually open. From today, you have true caller identity. There is no unidentified caller. Who is this mysterious person? Who is this demonic organism in my life? Who is causing me pain? Lord, reveal them. after you reveal them, Lord, burn them. Let them burn. The God who answers by fire. Reveal them, oh God. Reveal them and burn them in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, shine your light, Lord. Shine your light. Everybody who is listening to the sound of my voice this morning, my God, may you shine your light, shine your light, shine your light, and let there be no hiding place for the works of darkness in our lives. Let there be no hiding place for the works of darkness in our lives in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Jesus. Diva Star, God bless you. God bless everybody who's gifting. Hallelujah. Haria Kasata. There is a name that needs to be identified. Barrenness, I speak to you. Move. I command that barrenness to go in the name of Jesus Christ. Exodus chapter 23, verse 25 says, if you worship me, the Lord, your God, I will bless you with food and water and take away all your sicknesses. He says, I only demand to be worshipped. I am the Lord your God. If you worship me, I will give you food and water and take away all your sicknesses. He says, in your land, no woman will have a miscarriage or be without children. I will give you long lives. Do you understand that God has prophetically... not only is it a prophetic instruction, but it is a decree. Rulers who are kings, they decree, they legislate. He has legislated that when you worship him, you are not permitted to be barren. You are not permitted to miscarry. Now, I'm not only speaking to those who are physically expecting babies or who want to conceive. Yes, I'm speaking to you, but I'm also speaking to you guys who are business people, who are entrepreneurs. You are not permitted to miscarry. You are not permitted to miscarry your dreams. You are not permitted to miscarry your careers. You are not permitted to miscarry your marriages. You are not permitted to miscarry peace in your home. There shall be peace in your home. There shall be unity in your home. There shall be progress in your life. You are not permitted to miscarry. Fruitfulness is your portion. This mountain of barrenness in any area of your life, it has to be removed by in the name of Jesus Christ. He says, I will give you long lives. Don't say that in your family, you only live until 70. Don't say that nobody has lived beyond 50 years. You are going to live beyond. You will have long lives. Hallelujah. You will not miscarry in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God bless you, Diva Star. My Father, I commit to worship you and follow you. Somebody open up your mouth right now and commit to worship him and say you will follow him for the rest of your life. Commit to him. And he knows your motives. He knows he can judge your heart. He knows what is truly in your heart. He knows that those who are worshiping half-heartedly. My Father, we will worship you. Father, I stand in the gap for these ones who are listening to the sound of my voice right now. Lord, we will worship you. We will please you. And we thank you, Lord, that your word has confirmed that we will never lack as a result in the name of Jesus Christ. From today, from this place, from this platform, no one connected to us shall be barren in the name of Jesus Christ. Nobody shall be fruitless in the name of Jesus Christ. I commit myself. Yes, I love that. I commit yourself. Check your motives. Determine in your mind you're going to worship him. He's going to be your provider. He's your Lord. He's your sustainer. He's your provider. He says, I am Jehovah, I am Jireh. Do you understand that this man, when you call him by his name, equally when he tells you that every mountain has a name, he says, whatever you need, just activate the name. My God, hallelujah. Father, we agree according to your word, every sickness that is represented on these platforms, whether it is on YouTube, on Facebook, whether it is on TikTok, as they type those sicknesses, my God, that they've been battling with in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, I thank you, Lord, that you are taking away all those sicknesses and diseases in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, take it away. If you have any sickness in your body, command that sickness to go right now. Say, Lord, take it away. Mention it. If you are praying and standing in the gap of somebody who's sick right now and say, Lord, take away the diseases, 1, 2, 3, from this person. Take away cancer from my uncle. Take away sugar diabetes from this. Take it away, Lord. Take it away. You have promised, Lord, I'm standing here. I'm committing myself to worship you. Take it away. Every power that has been cutting short your dreams, every power that has been cutting short your purpose, every power that is saying that you will not mature to your destiny, we cut you short now. Cut that thing that is trying to cut you short. We cut short anything that is trying to cut you short.
Do not permit that thing to cut you short.
Father, we command every wrong diagnosis, everything that if they say, whatever they said, we only believe the diagnosis of God. My God. Father, we will not be confused. We won't be confused by wrong diagnoses. We won't be confused by negative thoughts. We won't be confused by human beings who are trying to tell us that we will not achieve what you said we will achieve in the name of Jesus Christ. Deal with confusion. Confusion is a spirit. God bless you, Nikki. Confusion is a spirit. In every area of your life where confusion is reigning, Lord, sort it out. Clearly and quickly. Ask him, Lord, sort out any confusion. If you are having confusion, even choosing a mate, God, sort it out quickly and clearly. I will not be confused in the name of Jesus Christ. The scripture we read in Zechariah, he says, size does not matter. He says, who art thou, O great mountain? He says, even if the mountain calls itself great, he says, he clarifies that size is not an issue. Tell your neighbor, size does not matter. Size does not matter. In the book of 1 Samuel, chapter 17, verse 3, the Philistines lined up on the one hill and the Israelites were lined up on the other with a valley in between them. Do you understand? Now, imagine now the Israelites, you are caught between a rock and a hard place. That is how they say on earth. Hallelujah. And in verse 4 of that chapter, it says, a man named Goliath from the city of Gath came out from the Philistine camp to challenge the Israelites. He was over 9 feet tall. But size did not matter for David. Goliath was there, a monster, dinosaur size. And the Bible says he wore a bronze armor, so he was protected. He had all the armor that would protect any arrow that would come. What he was wearing, the Bible says it weighed over 125 pounds. He was wearing a bronze helmet, so you couldn't even see his body. But if it is time to go down, Goliath must fall. Every giant must fall. Giants do go down and giants fall. This mountain must be removed. Hallelujah. The Bible says his legs were also protected by the bronze armor and he carried a bronze javelin. I don't care what they carry. I don't care which juju they say they are carrying. I don't care which shrine they say they are coming from. Oh my God. I want you to pray right now and say, I refuse to be intimidated. I refuse to be intimidated. I refuse to be intimidated by any giant. I refuse to be intimidated. My Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we refuse to be intimidated. I refuse to bow down to any CV of any Goliath. The CV of any giant does not threaten me. I refuse to be bowing down to Goliath. All Goliath in your life, I want you to tell them, I know your name. Declare it with me. Say, any Goliath in my life, I know your name. Any Goliath in my life, I know your name. I know your name. It does not matter what your name is. It does not matter who you are, O mountain. No matter your size, I don't care. You will not destroy me. I will overcome you. You will not destroy me. I will overcome you. Whatever it is, child of God, even if it feels huge or daunting, you will overcome it. I hear the Spirit of the Lord asking, can these dry bones live? Can these dry bones live? You tell me. Ask your neighbor, can these dry bones live? The dry bones that were caught in that valley, those dry bones in the valley, he led me all around the valley, and I could see that there were many bones, and they were very dry. Can these dry bones live? Sophie, can these dry bones live? Tell me, do you know the answer? He said to me, mortal man, can these bones come back to life? God asked the question again. He says, can these bones come back to life? And Ezekiel answered, he says, Sovereign Lord, you are sovereign, you are bigger. I don't know. Only you can answer that, oh God. And that's why we are gathered here this morning. We're saying, God, this thing is bigger than us. It is telling us it is bigger than us. But what we know is that you are sovereign. And when you have given us the word that we can move this mountain, then we can do it. Then God can give me the affirmation that these bones shall live again. These dry bones shall live again. These dry bones shall live again. Oh, receive the faith for the uncommon. Receive the faith to make the dry bones live. These dry bones shall live again. There are things that men can do for me. There are things that mankind can claim credit for. But this one, Lord, you can do much more than mankind can promise. You can do much more in this week, my God. As I start this week, Father, there is more that you can do for me. You can make the dry bones in my life to live again. You can make sure that the flesh comes into the dry bones. You can make sure that the dryness is taken away. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are the almighty sovereign God. Show your almightiness. Can somebody declare it in the comment section and say, show your almightiness. You are sovereign, my God. Show your almighty. He's the almighty. Do you understand the word almighty? Almighty is deep. Oh, Lord Jesus, before this end of June, show me, surprise me. Surprise me, Lord, before the end of today, before the end of 2023. Surprise me with your almightiness. My God, how am I doing for time? 10 minutes to go, we're closing. My God. I don't know who has been going through a season of famine. You have been going through a season of famine. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And the devil has been saying there's nothing heaven can do for you. They've been telling you that there's nothing your God can do for you. They are telling you that your prayers will not do nothing for you. I dare you not to give up. I dare you not to give up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In 2 Kings chapter 7, the Bible says Elisha answered. Hallelujah. Elisha answered like the way we started in Zechariah. God answered. Hallelujah. Listen to what the Lord says. By this time tomorrow, you will be able to buy in Samaria 10 pounds of the best wheat or 20 pounds of the best barley for one piece of silver. Do you understand that when the Lord has decided to give you the answer came through the prophet. Elisha answered. Somebody tell your neighbor, the Lord is answering this morning. Hallelujah. What they said could not be done will be done. The prophet came with the word. He says, by this time tomorrow, you will be able to overcome that famine. What you could not buy, you will be able to buy. He says, I'm going to level down the economy. I'm going to make sure that I paralyze the economy for your affordability. What you cannot afford, you will be able to afford. The house you could not build, you will be able to build. Talk to me, somebody. In the recession, when they say that you will not survive, he says, I will deal with the economy of Samaria, and I will level it down so that you will be able to buy food for your children and you will have provision. And he was saying this to the attendant who was an advisor to the king of Syria. The king of Syria was advancing against the Samaritans, and the Bible says in chapter 6 of 2 Kings, chapter 6, it says they had proceeded against Samaria and they had launched a siege. When you are launched in a siege, you are put in the center. You cannot go out, you cannot come in. Therefore, there was no means of provision to come into Samaria. The Samaritans were caught in a deadlock position. They cannot go out. They cannot do business. They cannot trade. They cannot get food in. They cannot get food out. My God. I don't know whether you have been feeling like a Samaritan and you're feeling like you are in a deadlock position. You are under siege. Do I have any people who are saying that I'm under siege? The Lord has sent a special prophetic word like he sent it in the book of 2 Kings chapter 7. He says, by this time tomorrow, hallelujah. And the personal attendant to the king did not believe it. He says, that cannot happen. It will not happen. He said, not even the Lord himself will make it happen. You will not even send you a grain of rice. He said, you will, and Elisha said, you will see it happen, but you will not get to eat it. Hallelujah. Elisha replied with confidence. He said, not only will you see it happen, but you will not partake of it. My God, Lord, 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 show yourself this morning. Hey, my says, my words are, you have been under siege. You are a candidate to remove that mountain this morning. Talk to me. Lord, use me as an example. Let that be your prayer right now. Say, Lord, use me as an example to confound the whole world. Use me as an example to surprise the whole world through my testimony. Let my testimony surprise my enemies. Not only will I see it, oh God, not only will my enemies hear about it, they will see my testimony. I will be a partaker of it. I will be the first partaker. That Kariaba Sonda, my enemies will show up and see me sitting at the table. Do you understand? He says, I prepare a table for you in the presence of your enemies. That table is meant for you to go sit there. That table is meant for you to go eat with the best cutlery. Stop delaying your victory. Stop delaying your celebration. It is time for you to go sit at the table of victory, at the table of celebration. Oh, Jesus. The world will see your testimony. The world will use you as an example, Madikelechi. Hallelujah. Lisiro, the Lord will use you as an example. You are the template, Hugo. You are the template, Happy 23. You are the example. Hallelujah. Not only will they hear about it, you will be the first partaker. Hallelujah. You will be the first one to charge. The four leprous guys were charging and they went to the camp of the Syrian army, and the camp of the Syrian army, there was depleted. There was nobody. They were gone. They had run away. Because God had launched an attack in such a way that the Syrian army thought that they were being attacked by an army. Four armies. They saw four armies, but it was the four lepers. And the four lepers had made up their mind. He says, why are we going to sit down here and die and we don't have any food? So let us charge towards the gate and let us go and get what we need at the gate. If I sit here, I die. If I go there, I might die. But if I go there, I might live. I might get the food that I need. So I'm going to make up my mind to take the step of faith, and I'm going to move, and I'm going to move this mountain. I'm going to take the step of faith. And when they got there, the Bible says that they got to the camp, and the camp had nobody in it. The soldiers had run away. The Syrian soldiers had run away, and the storehouses where they were storing their food, they had plenty of food. Everybody had enough to eat. You will be the first one there. The same way that the lepers got there first, the Lord is taking you from the back and he's saying, go. If you are ready to move this mountain, you will be the first one to partake of what you want. Oh, Jesus. I hope you are getting it this morning. Kala ba shoto koria ba ha. Ha. Before now, Kadia Basunda, I tend to come to the breakthrough party late. You were delaying your breakthrough. There was a celebration, but you will no longer be late to your own party. You were coming to your breakthrough party too late. Today you will be the first to arrive. You are the guest of honor. Hallelujah. Receive courage. Hallelujah. My father, we receive the boldness. Somebody make that prayer with me. I receive the boldness to confront every mountain in my life. 4 minutes to go. Let's go. Guys, push, 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 push in the spirit. Hallelujah. Father, we receive the boldness to confront every mountain in our lives in the name of Jesus Christ. My father, I thank you. It is written that the righteous shall be as bold as a lion. Father, every single person who's at the sound of my voice right now, I command and declare that right now, Lord, they are bold as a lion. My God, we are rejecting fear in the name of Jesus Christ. Nobody who is going to leave with this broadcast is going to be living here fearful in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My God, Father, the testimony that you gave in 1 Samuel chapter 7, that we have killed lions and bears. Father, we stand on the same testimony of David, who said, I have killed lions and bears. Who is this uncircumcised Philistine? I will deal with this uncircumcised Philistine. I will deal with this mountain. I will remove it. Who is that defying the armies of the Lord? I will deal with them. Father, we have that same CV, oh God. We are lion destroyers. We are bear. We destroy bears. We kill bears. We kill lions. We kill anything that is trying to stop our progress in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh God. Let the God of testimonies arise for you in the name of Jesus Christ. The God of testimonies will arise for you this morning. I decree and I declare that the Lord of testimonies will fight for you this morning. Hallelujah. He will fight for you and he will fight through you. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus Christ, I want you to declare and say, fortune, I will never fail again. Put your name and say, fortune will never fail again. Takunda will never fail again. Vimbai will never fail again. Mlisiho will never fail again. I'm a lion. lion and bear destroyer. In the name of Jesus Christ, I will not fail again. There is an effect. Hallelujah. There is an effect that is going to come out when you make that declaration. Then the mountain, the Bible says the mountains, what the mountains do before Zerubbabel, they become a plain, they become leveled. As you declare, I will never fail again, they will become leveled in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh my God. Oh my God, there is no mountain that is going to be effective against you. There is no mountain, any mountain that has been blocking your progress to move forward. Right now, I level you in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. If you are not interested in moving forward, then you are not praying along right now. But if you are interested in moving forward, I want you to declare it once more and say, this mountain must be removed. It must be removed. Hakariya basanda. The day you decide that you choose that this mountain is going to be removed, that is the day that you become active in your faith. That is the day that you become active and all the famine in Samaria goes away in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, any blockage that has been saying that I will be stuck in the valley of a Samarian famine, Father, deal with it in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, I speak against every blockade. Oh, Father, give me grace. Give me extra 5 minutes. 5 minutes more. Hallelujah. The Bible says sometime later, King Ben-Hadad of Syria led his entire army against Israel and laid a siege on the city. Father God, right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I'm coming out of that siege. Any siege that anybody has lodged against us, right now, Lord, we are coming out from it in the name of Jesus Christ. Every siege that is standing against my progress, I command it to be removed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I command every siege that is coming between you and your progress in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every siege against your financial freedom, I command it to be uprooted in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every siege against your spiritual life, against your spiritual destiny in the name of Jesus Christ, against your physical destiny, against your financial destiny, against your family's destiny, I command it to be uprooted in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I command the hand of the Lord and the fire of the heaven to consume any siege that is coming against you right now in the name of Jesus. That siege will catch fire. It will be consumed by the fire of the Lord. I command that siege to be consumed by the fire of the Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I command the blocked tubes to open right now. Those fallopian tubes will open right now in the name of Jesus Christ. You've been trying to conceive and you've been trying to get pregnant. I command it to be open right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Every blockage that has been stopping the flow of grace, every blockage that has been stopping the flow of power, every blockage that has been stopping the flow of favor, whether it is in your business, whether it is in your ministry, whether it is in your conceptualization of any idea, business, dreams, or otherwise, Father, destroy it in the name of Jesus Christ. Whatever the blockade is, I command it to be destroyed right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Anything that has been frustrating you, it is moving now in the name of Jesus Christ. My Father, frustrate those who are trying to frustrate me. Waste my wasters, oh God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Child of God, this is what you need to know. You need to know that there is no mountain that is not surmountable. No mountain is insurmountable. Hallelujah. It can be dealt with. It will be dealt with. It shall be made plain in the name of Jesus Christ. Who art thou, O great mountain? I command you to be leveled and to become a plain. I speak it in the name of Jesus Christ. Any form of repetitive failure, any form of missing opportunities has become a history in the name of Jesus Christ. As you rose this morning, as you stood up this morning and said, my future is moving forward. My destiny will become a realization. This mountain must be removed. I remove forms of repetitive failure. I remove that trend of missed opportunities. It has become a history in my life. In the name of Jesus Christ, I speak in the name of Jesus Christ. All self-destructive habits that we are under, Lord, let them be uprooted in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I speak in the name of Jesus Christ. I declare and I decree that you will have the last laugh. My God. Oh, I wish I could hear you pray right now. I wish I could hear you pray so at least I can see you pray. I can see you pray. Declare it and say, I will have the last laugh. I will have the last laugh. I speak it in the name of Jesus Christ. I will have the last laugh. I will have the last laugh. I will have the last laugh. Testimonies abound for you this week. Testimonies are abounding for you this week. By grace, receive your testimony this week. In the name of Jesus Christ, you will rebuild the temple as you put the last stone. As you go into this week, it shall be called beautiful. Your week is beautiful. In the name of Jesus Christ, you, God will be very kind to you. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord will replace that missing part in the puzzle. Any missing part of your puzzle, this week you will get it. The Lord is giving you a testimony. The Lord is giving you your voice in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord is giving you grace. The Lord is saying that you will receive your permanent rest in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Lord is going to be kind to you. The effect of grace shall be felt from Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, all the days of your life, this week and beyond, in Jesus' mighty name. I decree and I declare that you leave this broadcast with favor. I declare and I decree that your mountain has been removed in the name of Jesus Christ. Any obstacle, any mountain that was going to face you this week has been leveled plain in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord is giving you permanent rest. Receive your permanent rest in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody begin to thank the Lord right now. Father, I thank you. Father, I give you praise. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. This mountain has been removed. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody begin to thank the Lord. Somebody to begin to declare, this mountain has been leveled. It has been leveled. This mountain has been removed. 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 Father, this week is blessed. This week is blessed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody give Jesus a praise. Somebody comment in that comment section. Comment in that comment section. Say something to the Lord. Let it be a sweet incense. Send the incense to the Lord right now. Let your prayers go up. Let your thanksgiving go up. Let praise him right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, be involved in my week. Be involved in my week. Be involved in my Monday. Be involved in my Tuesday. Be involved in every meeting that I'm embarking on in this week in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I thank you for your mercies and joy forever for every single person who is under the sound of my voice in our families, oh God. We thank you, Lord, for the mercy over our life, over our families in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you for rebuking the devourer for our sake in this week, oh God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, for your outstretched arm over our family and everybody who is connected to us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. May you be glorified in our lives in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for good health in this week, oh God, that nobody will be sick. Nobody will fall sick in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you for healing those who are sick in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, for granting us good health. Thank you, Lord, for granting us a sound mind in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, that you are evident. Your presence is evident all over me, all over my business, all over my life, all over my family in the name of Jesus Christ. You will cause me to prosper on every side. The lines are falling unto us in pleasant places. We have a goodly heritage, and that goodly heritage shall be seen in our lives and throughout this whole week in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we give you praise. We give you praise, my God. We give you praise, oh God. I don't know where you are, but lift up your hands. Lift up your hands. Lift up your hands and just worship him. Lift up your hands. Even if you do it in the comment section through an emoji, lift up your hands. Father, we commit into your hands, Kariyama Sunda, as many as hands that are raised right now that are trusting you for a miracle, that are trusting you for a deliverance in every area of their life. My God, I ask you that you answer them speedily in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Answer them speedily in the name of Jesus Christ. Those sick, those ones who are afflicted, oh God, answer them speedily. Lord, may your healing hands rest upon them right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Begin to thank him right now. Begin to thank him. Shout that amen louder. As you say amen, you are saying, I stand in agreement with you, Pastor Fortune. I agree with you. It shall be so. So shall it be in the name of Jesus Christ. It can never be otherwise. Sickness is banished from your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Sickness is banished from your system in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, those who are trusting you for provision, Father, I thank you, Lord, that you are catering for their provisions this week in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray, Lord, that you send them help in the time of need, oh God. Send them help today. Show them you are mighty, God. Show them your mighty name, oh God. Any confusion, oh God, everyone that is experiencing turmoil or trauma, oh God, in their families, I ask, Lord, that you reign peace in their lives, oh God. Let harmony come in their homes, oh God. Let peace reign in their homes. Dwell in them, oh God. Let shalom dwell, the peace that surpasses all understanding, let it dwell in them, oh God, in the name of Jesus Christ.
I ask that you comfort every single person who's at the sound of my voice. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Moose. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I agree with you too as well. In the name of Jesus Christ. Diva Star, I agree with you too. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Anybody who has been grieving, anybody who has lost their loved ones right now, Father, let them be comforted. Console them, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let your joy be their strength. Anybody who has lost somebody who has been rejected, who has been threatened with a divorce, Lord, be their comfort right now. Let your joy become their strength in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we pray for our families, oh God. We declare that in this week, favor shall follow us. Favor shall follow our families as well. We have favor with God and we have favor with men in the name of Jesus Christ. Everywhere we go, Lord, let your holy angels encompass our families. Let your holy angels encompass us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We are prospering on all ends. We thank you, Holy Spirit, that you have fortified us. You have fortified us. We are strengthened. We are protected in the name of Jesus Christ. By the precious blood of Jesus Christ, you are protected in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, karabashata kadia. The Lord will pursue your enemies for you. You will not have to fight in this battle, but you will have to remove that mountain. Remember to speak to that mountain. Remember to prophesy to that mountain. This week, Lord, I overtake my enemies. This week, Lord, I pursue and I recover all. Everything that has been stolen from you, you will recover it all in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray for your finances. I pray for your business. I pray for them this week. This week, your finances, your businesses, you will see the evident presence of God in them right now. You will make profit. I prophesy, I decree, and I declare that you will expand. You will make profits in this week in the name of Jesus Christ. What was not working in your business, it will begin to work in Jesus' mighty name. Father, take over our finances in this week and beyond and into the month of June and in this whole year, oh God. I declare that the devourer is rebuked in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I thank you for a bountiful harvest in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. It is coming for them in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord, for answered prayer. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Jesus. Father, I thank you for these ones that have come out. Thank you, those who are loyal, oh God. Thank you, those that have shown their loyalty to you, oh God. Thank you, Lord, that they continually show up every 5 a.m. morning, oh God, to show their faithfulness, oh God, that trust in your word. Father, I thank you for every prayer that has gone forth, that has been answered in Jesus' mighty name. I thank you, Lord, that every decree and every declaration has been answered in Jesus' mighty name. And Lord, it will create that which we have sent forth with our mouths in Jesus' mighty name. God bless you. Thank you so much. You must have an awesome, awesome week, and you must have an awesome rest of your Monday. This is your week. Don't let anybody tell you otherwise. Remember, this mountain must be removed. Declare it once more as we are signing out. Thank you, Facebook. Thank you, YouTube. God bless you and increase you. Amen and amen. Don't forget, 10 p.m. 10 p.m. tonight, 10 p.m. That slot for Apostle Mara. Do not forget. Make sure you are following the platforms that you're on. Hallelujah. Who knows? Maybe I might be at that 10 o'clock. I don't know. I want to just gate crash that party a bit, maybe. Hallelujah. This is your week, Mbalicious. Hallelujah. God bless you. I love you. Go and conquer. Go and conquer. Brenda, you are blessed. Vimbai, you are blessed. Let me see who else. Can I see the names here? Hallelujah. Let me